الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. إن شاء الله تعالى we will be speaking about the six pillars of Iman. So inshallah, in brief, بإذن الله تعالى. So we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are in one of the masajid of Ahlul Sunnah, walillahi alhamd. And Ahlul Sunnah, there are very few. And we have been to many masajid. You find them either they are upon the Ikhwani Manhaj, the Muslim Brotherhood, or they are upon the Tablighi Manhaj, or the Takfiri, or the Khariji Manhaj. And our ulama, Sheikh bin Baz, rahimahullah, Sheikh al-Uthaymeen, Sheikh Rabi', Sheikh Ubaid al-Jabri, Sheikh Salih bin Fuzan al-Fuzan, and other senior scholars, they have refuted all these sect, deviant sect. And there are fatawa from the ulama about that. So you should thank Allah that you are in one of the masajid of al-Sunnah. This is a big ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us. Look how the books around the markaz. You see the book of Sheikh Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab, Sheikh bin Baz, Sheikh al-Uthaymeen. These are all the books we have here. Walillah, I want to make this thing clear, inshallah, that way you see al-fadl, the virtue of being in one of the masajid of al-Sunnah. Alhamdulillah, the administration, they are upon the aqidah of the Salaf, the manhaj of the Salaf al-Salih. And they're doing their best. We are not perfect. We don't claim that we are perfect. We do the best we can, but alhamdulillah, we are upon the aqidah of the Salaf, manhaj of the Salaf. We are not from al-ahzab, the parties. Walillahi alhamd. Look at, I've been to many masajid. Wallahi, some masajid, when you are there, when you listen to the lecture, you think you are in a CNN studio. All is politics. So, barakallah feekum, this is a ni'mah. Wallahi, it is a big ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you want to know the opposite, go to the other masajid. You see for yourself. If you have the furqan, the manhaj and furqan, the criterion with which you can differentiate between Ahl al-Sunnah and Ahl al-Bid'ah, you go to the other masajid and you see for yourself. After that being said, barakallah feekum, the pillars of al-Iman, al-Ulama, they mentioned there are six pillars of Iman. The first one, to believe in Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the most emphasized pillar of Iman. To believe in Allah necessitates that you believe in everything that He said in the Quran. Everything that He said in the Quran. And the Quran is three categories. It's either Tawheed, the matters of belief. Or it is stories of the Prophet and their nations. Stories of the Prophet and their nation. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He spoke about this a lot in the Quran. For example, in Surah Al-A'raf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about Prophet Nuh, peace be upon him, and his people. He spoke about Ibrahim, alayhi salam, and his people. And also Hud and Salih and other prophets, peace be upon them. He spoke about them and how they disbelieved in Allah and things like that, and how Allah destroyed them. So that we can take heed. We can take examples from that. Tayyib. Everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed in the Quran and also upon the tongue of His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the authentic ahadith. So we have to believe in that. Also, we believe in the unity of lordship, unity of worship, unity of Allah's names and attributes. So we have to actualize a tawheed so that we can give Allah His right. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. Worship Allah and do not associate anything in worship with Him. Anything is general. طيب. The second pillar of al-Iman, barakallah feekum, is to believe in the books that Allah revealed. In the books that Allah revealed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He revealed to His prophet and messengers books. From amongst them, Al-Injil, the Gospel. And the Zabur, the Psalms of David. And also the Torah that was revealed to Musa alayhi salam. And also Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Al-Quran. And the Quran is the last and the seal. So we believe in these books that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. Of course, some of them, they have been tempered with. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, that they have tempered with the book of Allah, with the books that Allah revealed. But the Quran, alhamdulillah, nobody can temper with the Quran. And also, we believe in the angels. We believe in the angels. So we believe in them in general, and we believe in them in specific as well. Like those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran and upon the tongue of His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like Jibreel, peace be upon him. And Jibreel actually is the leader of all the angels. He's the leader of all the angels. And we also Mikael and Israfil. Mikael is the one who is in charge of the rain. And Israfil is the one that blows the trumpets. One that blows the trumpets. And we believe in also Malak al-Maut, the angel of death. Some people, they call him Azrael. Azrael doesn't exist. Ulama, they say this word does not exist. There's no narration that supports this word Azrael. So he is Malak al-Maut. And also Malik, the warden of the Hellfire, he's the leader. So we believe in all the angels that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran and upon the tongue of His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those that we know and those that we do not know. Al-ulama, they mention that there is al-Bayt al-Ma'mur in the seventh heaven. Al-Bayt al-Ma'mur is like the Kaaba here. So every day, 70,000 angels come to worship Allah there. 70,000. And they don't come back. Imagine. 70,000. They come every day and they don't come back. I mean, we cannot even imagine the number of the angels. Allahu Akbar. This is amazing. Allahu Akbar. Shows you the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah, 70,000 angels every single day. They come to worship Allah as we worship Allah upon this earth. When we go around the Kaaba, they make tawaf. Same thing. 70,000 and they don't come back. Also, we believe in the last day. We believe in the messengers. We believe in the last day. And the last day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about it, في يوم كان مقداره 50,000 سنة. In a day that is 50,000 years. So that's Yawm al-Qiyamah. But you have to understand, some people may say, it's going to be a long day. It is going to be a long day only for the disbelievers. But for the believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it easy for them. He makes it easy for them. 50,000 years. Because you have to understand, in the hereafter, the time doesn't matter. You know that? Doesn't matter, because when you enter Jannah, do you have to look at the watch? You don't have to. You don't have to, because you live forever. So there is no, the time does not matter. You don't have to be looking at the watch every time. And you don't use the bathroom. You don't use the bathroom, like here we do. Because it's a deficiency. Over there, alhamdulillah, life is perfect. You see, you don't sleep. Sleep, Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen, he says, it's deficiency. Naqs. And it is deficiency. So if you don't sleep, you can't function, can you? You can't. You'll be walking like a zombie, right? So, subhanAllah, look, ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided this sleep for us so we can rest during the night and we can work hard during the day. Allahu Akbar. Amazing. May Alhamdulillah ala ni'amih. We thank Allah for all His blessings. And this day things happen in it. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, that on that particular day, the people will be resurrected. They will be resurrected to stand for judgment in front of their Lord, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, al-mizan, the scale will be brought. And also, hellfire will be brought. May Allah protect us from it. And on that particular day, the people, they will be put to judgment. They will be held accountable for whatever they have done on this earth. And the last thing is al-qadr, to believe in al-qadr. Al-qadr is preordainment. If you wish, you can say predestiny. So whatever Allah wills will happen. Whatever Allah does not will not happen. And Allah decreed all these things as it is in the hadith 50,000 years before he created the heavens and the earth. 50,000 years. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he knew everything before they could even take place. Before they took place. So he knew everything subhanahu wa ta'ala. He wrote everything. And he knew everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this matters of al-qadr can be good. Sometimes they cannot be good. But at the reality of them, like something may happen to you, right? That you don't like. But in the end, you find out it's good for you, right or wrong. So the qadr of Allah, all of it is good, alhamdulillah. All of it is good. Whether you have, you know, something good, that you're a businessman and you make a big deal, deal, and you get a lot of money, or you're a student, for example, and you pass the exam, or something like that. All this is good, alhamdulillah, good. And you should thank Allah for this ni'am. And if anything happens to you, you lose a loved one. This is something not good. You're going to feel, you know, the effect of it. You're going to cry. You're going to feel sad. You know, things like that. But you don't know. Khair in that which Allah has chosen. Al-khair fi makhtarahu Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you believe in these six pillars of iman, you will have serenity in your heart. You will have sakina in your heart. Because when you know that whatever Allah wills will happen, whatever Allah does not will not happen, then why worry? You should not worry. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all al-ilm al-nafi' wal-amal al-salih. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Sallallahu ala Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Jazakumullah.